When teachers engage in intentional and ambitious efforts to build vocabulary and content knowledge, they support students' literacy learning. In this classroom, the teacher supports vocabulary learning by focusing on morphology, the meaning of word parts. In today's lesson, the goal is to help students learn the meaning of common prefixes.
Okay, so we've talked about how some words have parts that have meaning. And we've talked about prefixes are parts of words that attach to a base word or a root, and it can affect the meaning of that word. So today we are going to talk about some prefixes and their meanings. In today's lesson, we looked at the example of unicycle, bicycle, and tricycle together to come to the meaning of the prefixes. And then they had words using those prefixes that they then sorted with a partner to be able to identify the prefix and sort it. And then we came back together again to talk through the meaning of those words. So I have some pictures here, and I want you guys to tell me what these pictures are.
A tricycle, a bicycle, and a unicycle.
Okay, so we have a tricycle down here, a bicycle, and a unicycle. Can you talk to me, looking at these pictures, what's the same about these pictures and what's different? What do you have, Emery? What's the same?
They all have wheels.
They all have wheels, yeah. They do all have wheels. What's different about them, Lyric?
They're all different types of bikes.
They're all different types of bikes. What makes them different?
Because they have different types of wheels and they're different shapes.
Okay, so the shape of the bike is different and they have different types of wheels. Let's look at those wheels. You have a unicycle, a bicycle, and a tricycle. Looking at the wheels, Gracie, what's different about the wheels?
There's three, two, and one.
There's three, two, and one. Which one has three?
The one on the bottom, the tricycle.
The tricycle has three. Which one has two?
The bicycle.
The bicycle. And which one has one?
The unicycle.
The unicycle. Okay. So we have three different ways to get around here, right? And they all have wheels, but there are a different number of wheels. We have one wheel on the unicycle, two on the bicycle, three on the tricycle. So let's look at the words now. So here, I have a unicycle. Here, I have a bicycle. And here, I have a tricycle, okay? So they all have that same base word, cycle. But the prefix is different, right? What are the prefixes here? What do you think? Go ahead.
Try.
Try. Yep, I'm gonna highlight it here.
By.
And
uni.
And uni. So uni here. Okay, so we have a unicycle, a bicycle, and a tricycle here. Three different prefixes that are attached to a base word and change the meaning, right? So a unicycle has how many wheels?
One.
One. So what do you think uni means?
One.
One, yeah. So uni is a prefix that means one. Show me one. All right. And a bicycle has how many wheels? Show me.
Two.
Two. So what do you think bi means?
Two.
Two. All right. And a tricycle has how many wheels? Show me.
Three.
Three. So what do you think tri means?
Three.
Three. All right. So here we have prefixes that have a meaning. And then they can attach to words and kind of tell us more about what those words mean, okay? So we have uni, bi, and tri, meaning one, two, and three. So I have some words that have these prefixes, and I have a page where you're gonna sort them, and I want you to sort the words by their prefix. As readers, it's really helpful and important for kids to know about morphology. They need to know that parts of words have meaning and be able to recognize them. It helps when they're decoding an unknown word to be able to recognize those prefixes and break a word apart. And it also helps them to understand the meaning of words they don't know by using the meaning of prefix. Okay, so you sorted them based on the prefix attaching to a word, and they all have that same prefix attached, right? So we're going to look at them and we're going to talk about them together. And we're going to think about how does knowing what the prefix means help us understand the meaning of that word, okay? All right, so let's start here. So this word unicorn, can you get a picture of a unicorn in your head? Yeah? What do you see in your picture of a unicorn?
A unicorn.
Okay, so tell me, what do you see? Like what makes it a unicorn and not something else?
It makes it like a horse, but
it's like magical.
It's a horse that's magical? Yeah. Okay, what makes it a little bit different from most horses you see?
Because it,
what do you think? Gracie, what do you think? What makes a unicorn different from most horses?
It has like something like a party hat that's skinnier from its head.
Okay, so you described it as like a party hat shape, but skinny, and it comes out of its forehead. It's a horn, right? And how many horns does a unicorn have?
One.
Do you guys all see that in your head? The horse with the one horn sticking out of its head? So a unicorn is a made-up fantasy animal, and it's like a horse, but it has one horn coming out of its head. And corn is like an old-fashioned word for horn. Let's try another one. All right, I'm sure most of you have probably worn a uniform before. Mm-hmm. Or you've seen people wear, what types of people wear uniforms?
I played football, we wore uniforms.
Yeah, so a lot of sports teams, they wear uniforms. So what's the prefix here?
Uni.
And what does that mean? Show me. It means one. So what do you think a uniform, an outfit that everyone wears. What do you think that might mean? How does, think about the prefix. How does the prefix help you know what uniform might mean? So on your football team, you all wear that uniform. What are you thinking?
It's kind of like one team that wears the same uniform.
Yeah, so one team all wears that same uniform. What were you thinking?
One group of people wears the same uniform?
Yeah. So they all have this, it's one look, right? It's one outfit for everybody. So everybody all has that same look for the uniform. So if I was working with a student and they came to a word that they didn't know that had prefixes and suffixes, I would coach the student to look at the word and try to identify any prefixes or suffixes. For example, if the student came across the word unimaginable, I would give them a prompt to check for prefixes and suffixes. And we had the prefix un, meaning not, and the suffix able, meaning able to. So then unimaginable is something that you can't imagine, unable to be imagined. So that working through that process will help a student to figure out the meaning of unfamiliar word they encounter. All right, let's look at a word with the prefix bi. So here we have bi-weekly. Bi-weekly, what are you thinking for bi-weekly?
Something that happens every 2 weeks.
Something that happens every 2 weeks. So the prefix bi there means what?
Two.
And then our base word is?
Week.
So it makes sense. It's something that happens every 2 weeks. Can you think of another way to use bi-weekly? We have two, we have week. What do you think?
That happens twice every once a week.
Okay. So something that happens twice a week can be described as bi-weekly too. Okay, nice. So when we work on morphology, our goal is for students to use it in their own reading when they encounter unfamiliar words. They should be able to break the word apart and use the meaning of the prefix or the suffix to be able to figure out the meaning of that word. And it's something that they can do on their own in the words that they encounter every day in their reading. All right, here's one. I'm interested to know if you guys know much about this base word. So we have bilingual. Bilingual. What do you know about bilingual?
I think it means that you can speak two languages.
You can speak two languages, right. So we know that bi is two, and then lingual sounds like language. So being able to speak two languages means that you're bilingual. What do you think you might say if someone could speak three languages? What might we call that based on what you know about prefixes? What are you thinking, Amory?
Trilingual.
Trilingual. Yes. If you can speak three languages, you're considered trilingual. All right. I think you're ready for try. Mason, can you talk to me about a triangle?
A triangle has three corners and three sides.
Okay. Triangle has three corners and it has three sides and it has the prefix?
Try.
Makes sense, right? A shape with three sides and three angles is a triangle. All right, picture a triceratops in your head. Do you have a picture in your head? Triceratops? All right, kind of show me with your hands. What does the head do?
It has like three horns.
Yeah, it has three horns. Does it make sense that it starts with the prefix tri?
Yes.
Yeah, so it's a dinosaur that has three horns. All right, triplets. What are triplets? Mason, what are triplets?
Three babies that are born at the same time.
Three babies born at the same time. Yeah. So three babies born at the same time are triplets. When they come to a word that they need to spell, a lot of times the meaning of the word and the base word really impacts the whole spelling. So for example, in the word magician, if a student is just using phonics to spell the word, they might not come up with the conventional spelling. But if they understand that magic is the base word and it's related to words like magical, they can use that base word and then their knowledges of prefixes and suffixes to come up with the proper spelling. So I want you to listen to these words. Triangle, triceratops, triplets. Did you notice anything about the way that it sounds there? What did you notice?
Triangle and triceratops are tri and triplets is trip.
Okay, so the I here is long, and then down here in triplets it's short. And with tri, that happens sometimes. Sometimes the pronunciation is a short I instead of a long I, but the meaning stays the same, and we don't spell it any differently. It's still try, but just keep that in mind that sometimes that sound will be a short I instead of a long I. Sometimes we're working together, especially when things are new or unknown, but as they get more comfortable and they have more working knowledge, they do a lot more together, working with each other, and then they also apply it more independently in their own reading. So as you're reading, I want you to pay attention to words that have prefixes and think about what the prefix means. And then how can that help you understand the meaning of that word? Because remember, prefixes attach to other words and they help you understand the meaning because they have meaning too. So you have to think about what the prefix means and what the word means and then what the bigger meaning is, okay?
Learn more at literacyessentials.org.